So my mum asked me to get her a Christmas tree ornament because my brother got her one. So she went, oh, can you get me one too? So I've got one from both of you. So I thought I'd make her one. And it's one thing my mum loves more than anything in the world, it's cushions. So I've 3D printed her a little Christmas ornament, which will hang from the corner, depicting three cushions. They're actually pillows. If you look at the aspect ratio, that's a pillow, not a cushion. But I couldn't find a cushion 3D file, and I don't work in mesh, so I don't have the skills to be able to kind of squash that down. So I just thought, well, they'll just be long cushions. So I've been having a nightmare painting these. This came off the Form 2 SLA printer in grey. And painting it's been really difficult because the Humbrol like Airfix style paint just doesn't stick. So what I've done is found some gloss spray paint that does stick, which is just a cheap kind of Screwfix brand spray paint. That does stick. And then a friend of mine had a brilliant idea, which is fingernail polish paint. Now this is the only one I could get off Amazon that would arrive in time, because it's nearly Christmas, so it's like, what are we on? 21st of December. This is the only one that would actually arrive in time, and they did a Christmas colours little set of all these different colours. I only need a couple of colours, but I got red and green and all sorts of stuff. This looks dodgy. I don't know if this is a good brand or not, but this looks like the kind of thing that would be on Fake Britain, that would they'd send to a lab and it would turn out it had all sorts of chemicals in. I don't know if these are good or not. They don't look too bad. The packaging looks awful, but whatever. So before I put anything on the cushions, I've got a bit of Form 2 support material off-cut. And I'm going to just paint some on. Do you have to shake these? Don't know if you have to do anything with them. Nice base coat. No, I don't have that. I'm just going to put a bit on. Oh, there's no sparkles in that. It's got to have sparkles in, otherwise it's just not. It's not a Christmas decoration. That's, there we go. Huh, yeah, there we go. I don't imagine many people with fingernails that look like this have ever done something like this. Right, so when it comes to curing this is UV cure. And I have, for work, this industrial UV curing oven. This is 1,000 watts. Now the UV curing things you use for fingernails are 65 watts, and they take 120 seconds, 2 minutes. I would imagine that at 500 watts, I've got it set on 500 watts, this would take maybe 5 seconds. I just hope that the UV light's not so strong that it causes it to bubble or burn or do something like that. Oh, base coat and no wipe top coat. Okay. Still got a sticky residue on it, but I can't imagine, I mean that's hard, but it has got a sticky residue on. Might find some acetone and just give that a wipe and see if the sticky residue comes. Right, I'm gonna paint the cushions on this wire rack or whatever this is, just so that I can get it into the oven without touching it. The experiment went rather well, by the way, with the green, so. I'm gonna give this a nice coat of the base. Oh, this is fun, I'm enjoying this. Right, so this is done from the oven. Very slightly tacky. I'm wondering if that might need a bit more time. I might crank it up to 1,000 watts. I'm impatient. Let's give that a go at 1,000 watts just to see if it's... Flip it over, and I'm gonna do the same to the back with the little pink base coat bottle. So I'm going to do this in stages and sort of cure as I go, because I don't really want to risk it dribbling or something like that. That's sticking to the plastic. Let's go. Well, it's certainly the effect I was looking for. This is definitely a good idea. Danny the electrician is full of good ideas. This was one of his best, I think. Right, let's give that a blast in the oven to dry that. Rather worryingly, this is at 1,000 watts. The paint looks like it's gone purple. It hasn't. Good. Very nice. I mean, there's a few little brush strokes in it, but I can touch that up. Right. That is absolutely rock hard. That actually isn't sticky at all. So maybe 1,000 watts is necessary to and the base coat's a bit sticky. So I'm gonna, uh-oh. I've got cushion blood on me. That's not good. I've changed the timing on the oven so it times 25 seconds, just so that it's consistent, really. Because I've realized that I've probably got to do about, I don't know, 10 exposures before this is finished. So I've got to do each side and then roll it over and each colour and all this other stuff. So it makes sense to set the timer up. 5, 4, 3. Ooh, this is exciting. Now I've spilled over a little bit, but I'm hoping that the gold, which I'm gonna make the middle one gold. I'm hoping the gold will cover that up. Right, so the red and green is pretty much done. I'm gonna do the gold now. One of the Humbrol brushes I've been fiddling around with is pretty good at getting the edges. So I'm going to do this gently because I need to cover up my mistakes here and sort of get a crisp line around here. So we'll see how that goes. Right, another thing to note, I keep getting nervous that this paint is gonna rub off onto the wrong color and ruin it, but obviously, it's cured, so it's absolutely rock hard, so it's naturally doing quite a good job of managing itself. There's a few really dark spots here which I'm going to have to cover quite thick. But all I've been doing is just daubing it on with the little brush on the inside of the lid, just to get it on there. And then once it gets a bit close to the edges, then you can start using the little arty brush to do the rest. I feel like I should explain why I now have "fook that" written on my knuckles. My friend Jason was talking on Facebook about getting hand tattoos, and I said he's a barbecue chef, and I said he should get meat and fire tattooed on his fingers, and he replied going "fook that," and I had a Sharpie nearby. So I thought I'd see how it looked. So now I have "fook that" written on my knuckles. Nearly done on this. It's all looking rather good. I'm just giving the whole model, is it a model? The whole ornament, whatever it is, a nice baking on each end, just to make sure that all of the paint gets a really good roasting. Oh no, I'm getting glitter on my phone. That's not good. Right, that's it. So now I'm gonna add the no wipe top coat. It's actually quite hard to see where you've done. I guess if you're doing a fingernail, you kind of do it in one pass. But in this, it's actually really difficult to see where you've painted already. So I'm just gonna have to try and be methodical and start at one end and work along. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter if there's a few little holes. I mean, the bottom line is these aren't fingernails, so they're not gonna have to survive being bashed around or picking at things. It's just gonna hang on a Christmas tree. So I guess it doesn't actually have to be as hard wearing as a fingernail needs to be. But I do wanna make sure that the paint is protected, because this stupid thing will probably stay in the family for decades now. So this will be hanging on every Christmas tree we ever have now. So I need to make sure that it lasts. Maybe it won't, I don't know. Oh well, if it manages one Christmas, I'll be happy. There it is, looking very sparkly. Surface is nice and smooth and it's not sticky. So I got some gold string from Hobbycraft. It's doing there. Cut off all the weird bent bits. What? Stuff doesn't. There you go. So this little gold string, will hang it up on the tree. Standard deal. Right, so there we have the finished cushion decoration. As to remind you, my mum asked me to make her or get her a Christmas tree ornament so she can hang it on the tree. So I made her that because she loves cushions. So all in all, the fingernail stuff worked really well. My hands are covered in glitter and no amount of rubbing them on my jeans is making me go away. So I don't know what's going on there. My phone case is also a bit glittery as well now, but I guess that's not a bad thing. The 1000-watt oven did a good job. This would have taken a lot longer because the cure time is 2 minutes, but in that oven it's 25 seconds. So I would have spent a long time sitting around and waiting for it to cure, because I probably cured that about 20 times between all the different sections. Good, I'll see what she says. Maybe I'll post a little picture of it hanging on the tree at the end of this video.